If Ted's visits along the main streets and back roads of New England prove anything, it is this. The man enjoys a good breakfast. The heartier, the better. That's why he's placing an order at Lou's.
In the mountains, morning begins with clouds and views of a peaceful Connecticut River. If you're looking for some action this time of day, head over the bridge to Lou's in nearby Hanover, New Hampshire. Problem is, you may not get a seat.
We breakfast and lunch. We do breakfast all day from 6 to 3.
Craig Morley is manager at Lou's, a staple here on Main Street since 1957.
You know, good service and great food. But then there's also the bakery. We're baking every night, donuts and crullers and muffins and pastries and things. Pies are always flying out of here.
Whether college students or politicians, if you're meeting up with anyone around here, you're going to be at Lou's.
They're going to come to Hanover. They're going to come to Lou's.
We head back down the road to Norwich, headquarters of King Arthur Flour. George Washington was president when a man named Henry Wood started the company, first importing flour from England and selling it in Boston. Nearly 200 years later, a little change of address.
So the company begins in Boston, decades later moves to Norwich, Vermont. Why Norwich, Vermont?
The last couple that owned the business, Frank and Brenna Sands, when they were sort of refocusing where they wanted to sort of settle in their retirement years, it was a location that hopefully you're discovering is incredibly beautiful. There's a lot to offer. Yeah.
Co-CEO Karen Kohlberg says the move to Norwich 4 decades ago was a chance to move away from sideline businesses and focus solely on selling and distributing King Arthur Flour.
Our heritage, King Arthur Flour, you know, it's founded on the purity, loyalty, strength, quality. Our mission is about building communities through baking. That's what we say.
The baking school, gift shop, and cafe attracts some 400,000 visitors a year to King Arthur's headquarters, aptly nicknamed Camelot. And like Camelot, King Arthur Flour is romanticized by its employees. Who can blame them? They do have an important say in the company, after all.
They're 100% employee-owned. We take into account our employees, our community, our environment, and our customers in all of our decision-making.
They're also encouraged to try new things. Jeffrey Hamelman is experimenting with locally grown grain in this batch of bread.
People don't think of wheat coming from Vermont.
Vermont, particularly the Champlain Valley, the western part of the state, was, during the colonial period, considered to be the wheat basket of New England. This would be an organic, naturally leavened sourdough bread.
Hamelman wasn't so happy with this loaf.
So the crumb is a little tight.
But to us everyday bread eaters, it's all about taste.
This is like the tastiest bread I've been into in like a decade.
Though we've done a lot of eating today, we did save room for dinner on Main Street, Carpenter in Maine to be exact, chef owner Bruce McLeod.
I like to think of ourselves as a friendly country style restaurant, good honest food, prepared fairly simply. I'm not a big believer in overloading with flavor. I kind of am more of a minimalist when it comes to taste.
McLeod will switch up the menu according to the season, but he also knows there are some things that just have to be available year round.
We have an ice cream sundae that actually has been on the menu since my predecessor 10 years ago sold me the restaurant. If I took that off, I would be in big trouble.
Still, regulars and newcomers are open to McLeod's experiments.
We were doing a scallop BLT, the BLT in quotation marks, because it's seared sea scallops. The bacon is actually smoked salmon that's been dried slowly in the oven. A little tomato jam along with fried green tomatoes. Popular favorite here is the avocado fries. You take some avocados, soak them for a little while in buttermilk, and that magically makes them even softer and juicier than normal. Roll them in a little rice flour, and we serve a little sweet and sour tomato dipping sauce.
Fried avocados, it's a thing. And it's good.
You know, unlike an artist who has to wait till they're dead to get the gratification, we get it right away when people walk out the door and say, hey, everything was wonderful. It goes a long way to keeping you getting up and coming into work in the morning.
Avocado fries, sign me up. Back to Camelot, better known as King Arthur Flour, the company holds knighting ceremonies for longstanding employees. During the ceremony, each employee is bestowed a name that reflects and honors his or her role in the company. Sir Jeffrey, the baker, whom we saw experimenting with locally grown grain, has since retired, but he told Ted he hasn't hung up his apron for good and hopes to share his knowledge through teaching. Ted is puzzled, but he's not giving up.
There's only three pieces left.
Only three pieces.
And neither one of us can figure out how
that's
that goes.
That's right.